Ender Lilies, Quietest of the Nights, is a 2D action platformer and Metroidvania from Adglobe and Livewire. As the last and youngest White Priestess Lily, your sole purpose is to purify the kingdom of Land's End of the Blight, a corrupting rainfall that drives people and creatures mad while granting them immortality. Much of the kingdom has already fallen into madness. Commoners and royal guards alike have been twisted into beasts and monsters. The previous White Priestess managed to bind the spirit of a faithful knight to Lily for her protection, as she's quite young and defenseless. This Umbral Knight is your first means of attack, and chimes in with limited exposition as you discover new areas or meet special enemies. The story is told through scattered diary entries and boss character monologues upon their defeat. Each one has a tragic history that fits the grim world, but none of their individual tales connected into a compelling larger narrative. Lily can purify these boss enemies and gain their spirits to help her on her quest. Normal enemies have secret boss versions hidden in the environments, where you can gain their attacks for yourself, but the main bosses offer new traversal abilities that allow access to previously unreachable areas. Lily's basic moveset evolves into a suite of double jumps, dashes, ground pounds, and aerial attacks, though movement in combat never felt as responsive as I would have liked. Contextually, it makes sense that Lily feels slow and floaty, and attacks lack proper feedback, since her spirits are doing these actions around her rather than Lily herself, but it still feels off. Relics will allow you to augment some of Lily's passive abilities, or grant new ones, like giving you a parry or slight buffs to attack or defense. You can only equip a limited number of relics, and they have varying costs, encouraging you to mix and match based on the situation. Thorough exploration pays off, as most relics are hidden in hard-to-reach corners of the massive map, and many are invaluable for curbing the high difficulty of the game. Thankfully, you are able to fast travel early on between save points, and you lose nothing upon death. Enemies are varied and thrown at you in frustrating combinations that will test your skill and patience. Many enemies approach from the sky, and the lack of any basic attacks that aim above can make those encounters a pain. Meanwhile, bosses aren't challenging to fight until near the end of the game, but look fantastic. Presentation is Ender Lily's strongest feature by far. Its gothic watercolor aesthetic is gorgeous. The scenery is highly detailed and gives dark and gloomy locations tons of personality. The musical score is also incredibly impactful. Heavy use of an isolated piano perfectly complements the dark atmosphere. Some areas even incorporate humming from Lily, while boss fights dial up the tension with panicked violins. I reached the ending after about 17 hours, but I ran into a bug that seemingly capped my healing ability to 3 charges, despite finding at least 4 upgrades for it. Thanks to a relic, I was able to occasionally bump that up to 4 healing charges, but the game became far more difficult as a result. Hopefully a patch can iron out that minor annoyance. Ultimately, Ender Lilies is a beautiful and haunting game that mirrors many of the same beats as Hollow Knight, one of my favorite games of the last decade. While its art direction is spectacularly unique, its story and gameplay aren't. Despite that, this is a very strong entry in the genre. Ender Lilies is out June 22nd for Steam and Nintendo Switch, and July 6th for PS4 and PS5 for $24.99.